Look at the manifestation of the evil spirits.
It can't work.
As you are sitting down, remember that okay, the demon can be arrested by the angels of the Most High.
What is your problem?
I want my daughter.
Never, Stefan.
So you say, let us talk, but now you start talking
okay,
never.
Okay, Stefan, let us talk. What is your problem?
I want my daughter.
For what?
You know why I want her. You know yourself.
For what?
You know my business with her is not from today.
Look, I know the time has come. You're going to release her. It's fine. But when she's there, she will never be established. Okay? And number two, that is why I take her out now already. That, Stefan,
don't worry.
It's like you are looking for me everywhere. You don't find me. You don't find me. Look, you don't push me. Don't push me.
You said let us talk. Now you want
problem. No, don't let them tag me like
but,
this.
But why you do you talk
because
with
because they make me hot. Let them leave.
They
me
make you hot. Okay, leave her. Okay. No, don't do that. You say let us talk.
What is it, Stefan?
Oh, you want my daughter now?
No, man. Claim Yasmina. I can even give you.
Which one?
Huh?
Okay,
Yasmina, I'll show you.
No.
Let
I want only
see.
Her.
No, man. Let
no,
me
no,
give
no, no.
You.
Look, you don't have to show me. I have my eye to see.
Yes, nice one.
No.
Take them.
You say what? Well, I want this one. You are giving me another people.
Check them here. They're nice, are they?
No, everyone choose what you want. Choice. You don't choose for somebody. I choose her. Come on, give my daughter.
She's not yours, Stefan. She was never yours.
But I'm telling you now, she's mine already. You can see the way she's shining. Because,
Stefan,
look,
you know this is spiritual things. The way we battle in the spirit. Look, I'm going to release her. She can go.
Okay.
Okay? Exactly. Within the next 5 weeks, she's gone.
Okay.
That is what your prayer was. It came to pass, Stefan.
That's it.
But she's not going with your God.
No. You are releasing her because of this fire. That's why I want her to go. That, you know me. I want her to go with my God. They are waiting for many people there at the door, you know. They want to escort them.
Give them, Stefan. Why? Give them. There's so many. Give
no,
them.
No. It is on the number. When I was reading the paper, she was on the number now, my friend.
Never.
Go on, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm free in Jesus' mighty name.
I remember I said to you, seeing people getting visa and I'm still seeing again now people getting visas and I'm seeing people traveling.
Good morning. My testimony goes as follows. During a Friday afternoon service, I received a welcomed prophecy. In a parable, it was revealed of a journey that lies before me. I was to go to China. I have since been successful in relocating to China and I've been working here for a year. My year's contract was coming to an end and I have been looking for an alternative role in China, but to no avail. On Wednesday, the 8th of April 2020, I received a spiritual attack. In a dream, I was being pursued by a cat. During the Friday service, I claimed my freedom as the man of God released a word of prophecy concerning a spiritual attack that reiterated my dream. That particular Sunday, my internet connection was unstable and I only watched segments of the live streaming. My mother sends me the condensed version of the preaching and instructions presented during the service. The man of God had declared that as a congregation, we ought to join him in spirit and approach God in prayer and dry fasting. I followed suit and connected to the move of God on the 15th of April.
I want to invite you. Everyone is watching me. Can we go to that mountain, that place of Bar Brazil on Wednesday that is coming next week?
Next week, join me on that mountain of Baal Perazim. I'll be there also waiting for you. We need to pray for the nation. We need to pray for South Africa. We need to pray for the economy of South Africa. We need to pray for your job. We need to pray for you when you come back out of this lockdown. We need to pray for it. We need to pray for the body of Christ, the church of Christ. We need to pray for it. For God to encourage it and strengthen the body of Christ. We need to pray for it. If we go to that place, Baal Perazim, we need to pray for your spiritual upliftment. You need to communicate. We need to pray for your intimacy with God. You need to communicate with the Most High God. God must talk to you. You must hear Him. There must be the business of receiving and giving good things. We need to pray for it. So I'm inviting you on Wednesday from 6 to 6. Say amen. From 6 to 6, enter in your room. There's no job. We are in lockdown. Let's take opportunity of this lockdown.
I streamed the 6 p.m. prayer with Apostle Stefan, which was exactly 12 a.m., midnight in China. Thereafter, I went to bed. That very night, I received another attack that really frightened me. I dreamt of loved ones who are still alive, but in the dream are dead and pursuing me. The following morning, I emailed my spiritual father, looking for spiritual guidance. Apostle Stefan encouraged me to follow the advice of 12 a.m. prayer hour, followed with Psalm 35. I currently live in what was regarded as the epicenter of the deadly COVID-19 virus, Hubei Province, mainland China. I was filled with despair and the constant fear of the unknown. While heading towards the end of my current contract, I was riddled with anxiety and actively seeking for a follow-up position. Since October last year, I did no less than 2 interviews per week, but to no avail. I remember during the Wednesday service on the 15th of April, man of God encouraging congregants, including myself, to offer the prayer of thanksgiving in accordance to the Bible, which contains supernatural power. He said it should not take you a month to test God and to see the spiritual fruit materializing physically in your life. To God be the glory. On Sunday the 26th of April, I received a friend request from a prestigious bilingual middle school I had applied to in recent months. I conducted my interview on Monday. By Tuesday morning, I was offered the position. After which I immediately went on my knee to thank my God. I was informed about the salary, and I negotiated and was offered more than what I had even suggested. To God be the glory. Is in accordance to the prophecy I had received in March 2019. I go from working at an English training center from Thursday afternoons to Sunday evening and annual leave. I will now work at a very prestigious bilingual boarding school Monday to Friday with winter and summer vacation. Thank you for taking your time in reading and listening to my shared testimony. Love, Portia Daniel.